kind of like, and then turn around like that. So she's in the front one, which fits better than the back one. I struggled to get it in the back one there. But if you take it, you have, see, even my hand and the straps in the way or the handle's in the way. When you get her out, put her in kind of diagonal and then push that in and you will get her in there, but it's awkward. It's definitely not grab and go. It's definitely not ease of use. Hello, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. Let's have a look at my best and worst grab and go bags. The bags that you can just grab without thinking, throw your stuff in and run out of the house wherever you're going. And the first of these on my best category has to be my Neverfull. So I'm getting this out of the way before we even start. All of my stuff is basically just grabbed and went and thrown and still in there from coming home from work. This bag, it's a black hole. It's a massive tote. Any massive tote is going to be a great grab and go bag if you literally are just throwing your stuff in and going. This fits everything that I could ever possibly need. I have a video on what's in my Neverfull work bag. Literally everything. It's like the kitchen sink. It's so heavy. It's just such a great, fabulous, fabulous bag if you just want something to throw all of your stuff in, get on with your day and off you go. And I think for me, for one of those type bags is a really large tote, the Louis Vuitton Neverfull can't be beaten. Now let's do one of my worst grab and go bags, and it's the mini capucines. This thing is so beautiful. It's stunningly beautiful. I adore this bag, but ooh, she's annoying. She is really annoying to use. And there's no getting around it. If you're using this bag on a night out and you're just carrying her like this, like look at her with this outfit. I'm still loving this, by the way. This is the Estier dress, only today I'm wearing it as a long vest. If you have this sort of outfit and this, stunning, striking, she's absolutely beautiful. I think aesthetically, one of my favorite bags, but not easy to use, not grab and go, not throw your stuff in, not easy at all. She is the mini capucines. She comes with the little attachments, the D-rings for the strap are across like this. And then I've spoke about this before, she has this flap in the middle. This doesn't move. This flap is stationary in the middle. This is stationary. There's the bit to put this bit in at the front to hold it in place. So it's not easy to use. When you're using this, you're playing Tetris. When I put my phone in, I have to diagonal my phone in and maneuver my phone in. I can't just open the flap and put the phone in. No, that would be way too easy. You have to put it in at the corner, turn it, put it round. Hold on. A lot easier to show you with said phone. You have to kind of put her like this and then turn around like that. So she's in the front one, which fits better than the back one. I struggled to get it in the back one there. But if you take it, you have, see, even my hand and the straps in the way or the handle's in the way. When you get her out, put her in kind of diagonal and then push that in and you will get her in there, but it's awkward. It's definitely not grab and go. It's definitely not ease of use. This bag is made for her look and her beauty and her stunningness. She is not made to take on a day where you're just throwing your stuff in and going out. I generally don't really wear this bag if I'm going shopping. I do sometimes if I'm going, say, to the designer boutiques where you're in a boutique for quite a while and you're taking your time and you're having a wee glass of water or champers and you're talking and you're not in a rush at the till and trying to get everything in and out often. Something like that, I can cope with this during the day. But if it's to your normal shopping and there's queues and there's people waiting and you're moving along, you're trying to get things out and the phone's ringing and a child wants this and you're trying to get a card out and you're trying to get a key and we're, no, don't even think about it. No. Back to one of the best grab and go and it's the Birkin. I just dump everything in here. And I know she's very, very expensive. And I know she's the Birkin. And I know she's the Holy Grail. Bow down to you. I just throw everything in. I take this bag shopping. The only thing that maybe makes her not the easiest grab and go is this could be a little bit easier. For me, I'm only 5'1", so my arm actually fits in there perfectly. I don't carry it in the crook of my arm. I don't carry any bag on the crook of my arm. This is the Birkin 25, wouldn't fit on the crook of your arm unless you've very, very slim arms. But I can get it onto my wrist if I need to be hands-free for a moment. But I generally use this bag, carry this bag like this, and go. Put everything in. Phone in, wallet in, keys in, lipstick in, AirPods in, everything in. And then when I go shopping, and I have disgusted a few people with the photos on my Instagram, I just put the stuff in there too. Unless I'm going for a big shop where it's all in the trolley, if I'm picking up a few things, a drink, something to eat, a snack, I've had shampoo in here, I just put them in and off I go. I find this bag really, really easy. I think the Birkin is as precious or as casual as the person using the Birkin. If you want to be, I suppose, a lot more careful because this bag is the money that it is and it is the Birkin, then of course you're going to be more cautious about what you put into her. When I decided to buy this bag, given how expensive she was, I decided if I was going to spend this amount of money on a bag, she was going to get used. And I wasn't going to be precious about her. And I'm not stupid. I don't kick her about down the street. But I do use her. And I do just put everything in. And that was a conscious decision I made. And it makes this bag, for me, such a great grab and go. Really easy to use. Really, really carefree. I think she's a fabulous bag. And I think she just, for me, is such a good addition. Being a smaller tote. Brilliant bag. Next on the not so good grab and go bags is the Chanel Mini in lambskin. Now, the Chanel Mini is not the issue here at all. It's the lambskin. And I know that a lot of people say lambskin is more durable than it gets a reputation for. Lambskin is a better wearing leather than it gets a reputation for. I'm just more cautious of it. I can't say, and I'm not somebody who's very overly cautious, as you've just seen with the Birkin. I definitely use my bags. I definitely don't baby them. But the lambskin, I do think about what I'm wearing or where I'm going. Now I don't, oh look, I was about to tell you that there's no colour transfer in mine. There isn't, but can you see? You might not be able to see it because it's very, very small. There is a little bit of rubbing along the edge here. So you can see the crease in mine because this bag gets used. This is one of my favourite colours. I love this bag. If you watch my vlogs on this channel, you will have seen this bag feature quite a bit because I absolutely love the colour. But in so doing and using her like that, there is a little bit of rubbing along the edge of the Mona Lisa smile pocket here. And that has clearly just been from me using her and general use. There's no colour transfer, but you do need to be more cautious, I think, of lambskin. And I know people will argue against that, but my personal view in owning a few of these bags is that I'm more cautious with lambskin. If I was going somewhere that was raining heavily, I wouldn't take this. If I was wearing a certain outfit and I was going to have this bag crossbody for a long time, I probably wouldn't take it. Now, I have worn this bag crossbody with denim. I have. I'm surprised there's no colour transfer at all on there. But if I was going to be out, say, for a full day and this was going to be sitting against dark denim, I probably wouldn't take this one because I would be conscious of the lambskin. Oh, look, I haven't looked at this bag up close because I don't inspect my bags when I use them. I just use them and put them back on the shelf and move on and use the next one. But if we're looking for the cautious of lambskin or what can happen, there's corner wear. It's not huge, but to give you a full idea of what I mean about not being, you can see it there. There's corner wear. There's corner wear here as well at the very back, although not as much. You can see if I just kind of catch the light across that, you can see nail marks and scrapes and stuff because the bag obviously gets put down a lot. And then there's corner wear here as well. And that's just from general use. And that's why lambskin is not a grab and go. For me, it's not. I have to be more cautious with it. I don't grab and go with this and take it as many places I would want to. And you can see that there is some corner wear and some back pocket wear on this. Now, look at her. Look at her against this outfit today. She's beautiful. That's not going to stop me loving this bag. That's not going to stop me using this bag. That's not going to make me think, oh, I can't, I regret buying that in lambskin. Absolutely not. I'm still going to use this bag and I'm still going to love this bag because I have no intention of reselling this bag. So those bits of wear, they're just beauty marks like me along the way as we've got older together. But if you are looking for something that's carefree, easy grab and go, I wouldn't go for lambskin. Flip side of that, I'm back over to one of the best grab and go bags is a Caviar Mini. Now, obviously this is one of my best grab and go bags if I don't need to carry a lot. So if all I'm carrying is my phone, my card holder and a key and maybe a lip product, then this is one of my best grab and go bags and it is the Caviar Mini. I had this bag with me at my children's school fair just the other night and I just put it across me. I was wearing a summer dress. We were at the fair. They were getting their face painted. There was tattoos getting applied. We had food from the food stalls. We had ice cream from the ice cream stalls. The children were playing. There were lots of things going on. There was lots of opportunity for things to get dropped on this, for this to get marked, for this to get set down on the ground. And I didn't have to worry about it. I didn't have to think about it. It didn't even cross my mind that this might not be an appropriate bag to bring. I think a Caviar Mini of any Caviar Chanel bag, I think, as long as the shape works, is just so carefree. This bag has got a lot more use than the other one that I've just shown you, even though the other one is my favourite colour. And I don't see any signs of wear. I don't see any corner wear on this one. And I don't see any rubbing on the back pocket. And that's because it's Caviar. This is just, it's such a good, durable, wearable, easy to use grab and go bag. I wish they would bring minis back out in Caviar. I think they're fabulous. Such an easy to use bag for a smaller bag that you don't need to worry about. Back to one of my least easy to use grab and go bags, and it's the Papillon trunk from Louis Vuitton. And there's two reasons for this. The first is that you have to line this up properly to get this to hang properly. So this has two sets of D-rings on the side. On the top one is where I attach the thick bandolier strap, and on the bottom one is where I attach this strap. If you don't put those on in the right way, this bag will twist. When it's on you, it will not hang properly. When it's across you, it will not hang easily. It's meant to hang sitting like this. So you're meant to have this bag across you and then the chain hangs below. If you put this on the wrong one, it'll do this. It'll turn round, it'll spin round, it'll be very awkward. It'll be annoying and it won't sit the way it's meant to sit. So you have to line this up with the straps properly and make sure you have it sitting properly and in the right hooks before you go anywhere. Then this bag, before we keep going, I love these bags, but I'm going to give you the honest of what's not good grab and go bags. This has the S-lock, the same as the trunks do. When you're wearing this bag, because of the shape of it, that worked that time and made a mockery of my point. But there are times when you're wearing this bag, it's not the easiest to get this in and out. Depending what's in the bag, I'm holding it up. If you're not holding it up and it's hanging crossbody, it can be a little bit awkward getting that back in and out and lined up properly. So this, as much as it's a beautiful bag and it's the monogram, which is very, very durable in the canvas, and I think it's stunning and I love it, it's definitely not one of the easiest grab and go bags in my collection. Back to one of my best grab and go bags, and it is the Chanel 19. Mine is in the small size, mine is in the goat skin, and it is the black with the multi-tri color hardware that's every color basically. I like a bit of tack, so I like the big CC here and I like the multicolored hardware. I really like this bag. This is one of those bags that I have said so many times that fashion meets functionality for Chanel. I think this is such an easy to use bag. You just turn the little lock and in you go, and this fits. I don't even know what I still have in there, but this fits everything that I need to use. I have an organizer in mine. It does have one zip product, It does have one zip pocket across the back, and then I just use this space. Now, it's not the biggest bag. It probably looks like it would hold more than it does. It will hold your phone, your wallet, your card holder, say, your key holder. It'll put your lip gloss in. I can put my sunglasses across the top. It does have this large pocket in the back, which does fit your phone. So it does put everything that I need to use. But when I'm not working, I don't carry a huge amount. So there are bigger sizes of this. If you needed to fit in anything that's a bit more substantial, you might need to go up, but I prefer the look of the small one. And for me, this is a fabulous grab and go. What helps as well is that it's black. I don't have a huge collection of black bags. They're not my preferred bags. This one is the one that I go to a lot if I'm going shopping for the day, if I'm wearing my leather jacket. I love the look of this. Again, even with what I'm wearing today, I think this looks really, really well. The only thing about this that you might want to consider for a grab and go is if you're going to be out all day and this is very full, it can get heavy because it's got lots of chains and it's a leather bag. So this can get a little bit heavy pulling on your shoulder. But apart from that, as a grab and go, this is a bag I can just throw my things in and go. When I say throw my things in for all of these smaller bags as grab and go, it's when I'm not bringing very much. Obviously, if you were trying to carry a few more things, they're not grab and go because you're going to have to Tetris in them and they're not going to fit. But if you're only carrying a few things and you're throwing them in here, this is a perfect bag for me as a grab and go. This is one of my favourite bags in my collection, but it's definitely not one of my best grab and go bags. It's the Petite Malle. It's stunning. You can wear this crossbody. I wear the pink one over there crossbody quite a lot. I haven't worn this one crossbody. This is a statement piece. This is something to go out with and have a moment with. She is a vibe. This is not an easy grab and go. It does fit a phone. It does fit the iPhone Pro that I have. It fits my card holder and a lip product. Probably not a whole lot else. It's definitely not a grab and go. It's definitely something that's a bit more awkward to use, but is stunning. If you're using it as a clutch and that's all you're taking, then it's easy enough. But if you're talking about just throwing it across you and going, this is not the bag that you're looking for, but then this is not made for that. This is not made to be a grab and go bag, but it's a stunning bag and it's one that I've no regrets in my collection. I absolutely love it, but certainly not something I would grab for ease of use. Next on the easy grab and go bags, I'm going to put two together, and it is these both Chanel seasonal flat bags. One is a lot larger than the other. Take this one first. This is just the quintessentially grab and go, easy to use bag. Now, I've made mine slightly less easy to use by putting these brooches on it. Because of that, you've got to be a wee bit more careful. You wouldn't be just as happy banging this about the place with these brooches because they could get damaged, they could fall off, you could hit them, you could chip them. That makes this one a little bit more precious, but that's my choice. I've put them on there. So that's not something about the actual bag. But if you're looking at the actual bag, and I will show you an insight into my life. This is obviously a bag that I have grabbed and went pretty recently. And we have a Lego police car. We have a Lego police car. We have a Lego truck. We have some more random pieces of Lego. Tissues. Band-aids. Glamorous mother of two. That shows you basically how grab and go this is. I've obviously had this out recently with my children. Their Lego is still in there. Their toys are still in there. This is something, it's large enough. Everything goes in here. I can get my book in here whenever I'm taking them somewhere and I'm going to be sitting waiting on them. I put my book in here. I put everything I need, my phone, my wallet. I have their juices in there. I had both of their juices in there. And then this bag either can double up on your shoulder and can be worn really, really easily on your shoulder. Or I have got one of the little clips from Amazon. What side's it on? There's a little clip from Amazon on one of those sides there, which has shortened the length of this to make this also a really easy crossbody length. This is a bag I don't worry about. Apart from those brooches, I don't worry about this at all. I think this is a fabulous, fabulous version of a grab and go, functional, easy to use Chanel bag. And this one also, now this is smaller. So again, this is a grab and go if you're looking for only taking your phone, your card holder, and you're not throwing everything in, like the children's juices and your book and all of those Lego pieces, which are vital to a day out, let's be honest. But if you're taking a smaller amount of stuff, this is so easy. I have worn this crossbody a few times since I got this. It's not the longest of me crossbody, but it's okay. And it's just so easy to use. It's maybe because it's pre-loved and it already has a few marks on it because it is fabric. So I'm not taking either of these out when it's lashing rain. That's the one thing I will say takes away from their ease of grab and go and use. But if you have a dry day, this is so easy to use. It's just, it could be because it's already marked. So I'm not that worried about marking it again myself. But I think seasonal Chanel flat bags, if we take that category in general, is a really good option to look for a grab and go Chanel bag that's not going to be too fussy, isn't going to be just as expensive as what the classic flap is going to be, and will come in sizes and fabrics that are easy to use and that you can just put your stuff in and away you go. This is a bag that I thought was going to be an easy grab and go bag, and it's not. It's annoying. It's annoying to use. I have a video, a review of this. If you're interested in this bag, make sure you watch it, because you need to know the annoying bits before you spend your money and buy this bag. It's stunning. It's beautiful. I thought this was going to be a bag that I could throw across me and just go without even thinking about. It's not. The zip's annoying. Getting in and out of it's annoying because of the shape. It's awkward. On ease of use, I thought this was going to be so good. It's not. It's not the easiest bag to use. It's definitely not something that when you're in shopping, you don't need to think about. It can be annoying. And last on my best easy to use bags, if you don't need to carry that much, this is a mum bag. It's so easy to use. I don't think it's at its height of fashion anymore. I think it's had its day. I don't know if I would buy this now at its current price after the Louis Vuitton price increases. This is nearly £2,000. But for just throwing across me, if I need my phone, my card holder, I need my key, my lip gloss, I also have my very vital poo bags in here because we pick up after our dogs in this house. I have pens in here because goodness knows what I need to scribble down. I have sweetie wrappers in here that I'm going to blame on my children. This is easy to use. As long as you don't need to carry a lot, it's so light. It sits so flat to your body. This strap is really light with it. It has the two compartments that you can keep some organization in there. I think this is a really, really easy to use, fabulous, utilitarian, everyday, grab and go mum bag, as long as you don't need to carry a lot. Has a wee tiny bit of fachetta on it. I'm not really gonna worry about getting a bit of rain on that. It's all monogram canvas, which is very, very durable. This is a fabulous grab and go bag if you're not carrying a huge amount. And the last bag on my least easy to use grab and go is the Chanel Classic Flap. I don't think this is made to be a grab and go bag. I think this is made to be beautiful. And I know that whenever it was designed by Coco Chanel way back in the day, it was meant to be to fill a need of being easy to use for what she needed it for. It has this double flap, so when you open it, you have to lift this out of the way and hold this out of the way to get in. It actually, this is the medium size. This actually doesn't hold a huge amount. So you're putting your stuff in there and tetrising it a wee bit. But with that being said, most of the bags I've just said are easy to use are very, very small. So small bags work for me. I don't carry a lot, but if you're someone that needs, this looks like it would hold more than it does, and the medium looks or sounds like it should hold more than it does. So it doesn't hold as much as you think it would. Because of the double flap, which does keep its shape, it does get heavy whenever you're carrying this, if you've got anything in it. I had to get the chain on mine extended to make this comfortable for me to wear under my shoulder or crossbody. The length, which is still the traditional length on the pink one over there, is okay as a shoulder bag for me personally because I'm curvy. It's too short crossbody. Mine is caviar. That is very durable. That is easy to use. But I just think this bag in general, with its design, with its chain length, with the double flap, with it not fitting as much as you think it would, is not the easiest grab and go bag in the world. If you're looking for a grab and go bag, I don't think this is what you're buying. So that is a rundown of my best and worst grab and go bags. And I hope if you're looking for any of these bags or thinking about any of these bags, it gives you an insight into how easy they are to use and whether or not they're just get your stuff in and away you go, or you need to be a bit more fussy and a bit more fiddly, and let's be honest, they're a bit annoying. I hope this has been helpful for you. If you have enjoyed it in any way and if you found it informative, please do consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet, please do consider subscribing. Let us know what you have as your best and worst grab and go bag in the comments so as we can keep the information coming. Thank you so much for watching. If you're not done with me yet, I'm going to leave another one on the screen. Please take care, and I will see you again in the next video.